We will now discuss about the natural kuntas within a watershed. In several areas, we have small percolation tanks, usually called as kuntas, kunta, in most of the areas in Andhra Pradesh. These are not intended for irrigation. They are intended either for drinking water purposes, which are even called as Vakiranis in Anantapur district, or could be even for drinking water of cattle, washing clothes and things like that. In many cases, they work as mini percolation tanks. That would be recharging the water table. In a watershed of 500 hectares, it's likely there may be several kuntas of this type, and some of them would need rehabilitation. That means either the bund may require strengthening, or if the bund is breached, it requires closing of the breach, or if the spillway or the surplus weir is not in condition, it requires repairs. So these kuntas within the watershed will have to be rehabilitated, and after rehabilitation they can be given to the farmers for maintenance. Watershed committee will have to take care of the maintenance of such kuntas as usual with the other structures within the watershed. Now these kuntas existing already will have to be given highest priority because the work is already there on ground, and they would recharge the water table significantly, and they are already done in most of the cases through the villagers' cooperation. Many of these kuntas are constructed as a joint venture of the villagers. So it's easy to maintain such kuntas. In addition to these kuntas being maintained properly, there may be a need for desilting such kuntas. The storage would have come down, or the percolation rate would have come down. So therefore, there would be a need to desilt these mini percolation tanks. The desilted soil can be used by the farmers for additional manuring purposes in their infed lands as well as in their irrigated lands. The costs required for desilting as well as for rehabilitation could be met from the watershed development funds. We will now discuss a few issues pertaining to the minor irrigation tanks, the problems related to desilting, as well as supply channels to the minor irrigation tanks. Under Niru Meru program, separate budgeted funds are made available for desilting several minor irrigation tanks. These tanks are under the maintenance of Panchayat Raj Department if the command area is less than 100 acres, and if the command area of the tank is more than 100 acres, they are under the maintenance of the irrigation department, the minor irrigation wing. Now these tanks are getting silted up over decades of its life, and it is needed to improve the storage in the tank by removing the silt. When such irrigation tanks have to be desilted, the first requirement is that such desilting should be done in the live storage area and not in the dead storage area. A clarification is needed here. What is dead storage? The dead storage area is that which is below the sluice level, below the sill of the sluice level, which means that any storage in this area cannot be drawn through sluice because it is lower than the sluice. The life storage area is the one which is above the sluice level. Any storage in the life storage area can be drawn by the sluice to supply water to the fields. If in case the capacity of the tank is reduced by siltation, it is essential that the storage in the live storage area has got to be improved by removing silt in that area only. In many cases, it is observed that the desilting is done in the dead storage area. Some farmers prefer the silt here in the dead storage area for carrying it to their fields as they have better manure content. Some farmers especially ask for this type of silt to improve their lands. If that is the case, then it should not be called as improving the storage in the irrigation tank. It could be done for fertilization of the fields, and the farmers can themselves use their resources for excavating that silt and take it to their lands. The excavation need not be done by government using the government funds, because it's not benefiting the tank in restoring its old storage. In some cases, some of the people mention that, sir, if the desilting is done in dead storage area, it will be available as water body for usage during summer, and it could also be developed for pisciculture, and it will be also useful for drinking water of cattle, and therefore it would be advantageous to do it in the dead storage area also. If that be the case, then it can be planned according to that. For example, if desiltation has got to be done in the dead storage area for the purpose of providing a water body, either for pisciculture or for the cattle usage, then it has to be done in a methodical manner, not by putting a pit here, a pit there, and then disconnected pits and things like that should not be there. We should aim at one big water body, usually a circular water body with sufficient depth, a little away from the main tank bund. Because when deep trench or deep pit has got to be excavated, it should be at a distance of 10 times the height of the bund, so that any such deep excavation may not endanger the stability of the tank bund. Now, one has to plan this, and a circular water body has got to be built with sufficient depth so that the evaporation losses may be brought to minimum and the depth of storage is made considerable. The idea behind this is that the water would be available for a longer period in summer, and the evaporation of the water in summer will be reduced to the minimum. And such a work should not be termed as desilting for improving the capacity of the tank. The purpose is different, and if it needs that type of activity, it can be programmed and methodically done. The same is the case with regard to pisciculture. We should have water in the pit for most of the summer period, or almost continuously throughout summer, and then the pisciculture can develop. A pit here and there in the dead storage area will not solve the problem or will not help pisciculture. Some people even say that even if you do in the dead storage area, will it not improve the recharge to groundwater, and will it not be available on the downstream side and such improved groundwater recharge is anyway beneficial. Here we have to consider whether the tank is intended for irrigation purposes or for percolation tank. If it is intended for irrigation purpose, then the deep percolation has got to be minimized, because the water stored in the tank will have to be used for irrigation purposes and we should minimize the losses. But on the other hand, if the tank is a percolation tank, yes, it can be done in the dead storage area, because it increases the deep percolation as well. And there is no question of live storage and dead storage in the case of a percolation tank, because there is no sluice. So it can be done anywhere, and if the farmers prefer it in the dead storage area, it is equally good. So this is with regard to the desilting in the irrigation tanks.